Okay.
Good evening. I call the meeting to this, the Committee on City, on Finance of the City Council to order for today, Monday, April 1st, 2019. It's 7:05 p.m. Welcome. This is actually my first rodeo at this particular podium. So hopefully I won't fall off too hard.
Hey. Oh, Dennis, okay.
Before we begin, I was contacted by Councilor Sullivan stating that he has some family matters that he has to take care of, and he wouldn't be with us. I haven't heard anything from Councilor Monahan or...
There he is.
Councilor Monahan, thank you for joining us, sir. Appreciate you being here. Thank you very much.
I was going down the elevator, trying to...
Well, I took a ride on the elevator and it worked out real well, so I'm glad that's working out, and it's a good job by our former council president and dean of the council for working with the folks about that. I saw the meeting on television. It came up pretty well. Let's begin our meeting here. Madam Clerk, item number one.
Total appropriation of $20,000 from information technology full-time to information technology overtime. Invited Bill Santos, ITC Director, Troy Clarkson, Chief Financial Officer.
Mr. Santos, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
Do you have a statement for the folks up here?
Well, first, I want to explain what this is, if I could. As Mel mentioned, it is just a transfer coming from our full-time into overtime. And the reason for it is we had a National Guard member deployed to support Operation Enduring Freedom.
Okay, good.
And he'll be gone for, his time was 400 days, so... We'll probably be with Adam for several more months.
Motion for favor, recommendation.
Second.
The
motion has been properly made and properly second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Favor, recommendation it is. Madam Clerk. Thank you, Mr. Santos.
Thank you.
Number two.
Total grant award in the amount of $174,189.43 from Executive Office of Elder Affairs Fiscal Year 19 Formula Grant to City of Brockton Council on Aging Fiscal Year 19 Formula Grant Fund. Invited Troy Clarkson, Chief Financial Officer, Janet Fitzgerald, Director, Council on Aging.
Mrs. Fitzgerald, how are you?
I'm well, thank you. Good evening, everybody.
Welcome to the council chambers.
Yeah, looks nice.
Did
looks
you
nice.
Take this, the elevator or the stairs?
I took the elevator. I had my husband on the phone because it stopped and the doors didn't open.
It's beautiful.
It's very nice, yes. Good
nice.
Job.
Now you're here about your grant?
Yes.
Could you possibly explain to us what this is, what this, these funds are used
for? Sure. It's our annual formula grant from the state. It's used to pay for salaries, some expenses, operating costs, energy, printing, things like that.
Motion to recommend favor.
Second.
Motion has been properly made and properly second. All those in favor of the recommendation? All those opposed? Thank you very much.
Enjoy the rest
of your afternoon.
You too.
Thank you. Madam Clerk, number three.
Acceptance and expenditure of the total grant funds in the amount of $6,240.03 from Executive Office of Public Safety and Security Office of Grants and Research Highway Safety Division Fiscal Year 19 Traffic Enforcement and Equipment Grant Program. Two, City of Brockton Police Department Fiscal Year 19 Traffic Enforcement and Equipment Grant Program Fund. Invited Troy Clarkson, Chief Financial Officer, John Crowley, Chief of Police or his designee, John Hallisay, Captain, Traffic Commission.
Good afternoon, Captain.
Good afternoon.
You have a quick statement for us, or?
Yeah, this is a grant.
No
initial
match.
Funding was $3,360 for the winter impaired driving campaign from December 1st that ends March 31st. This is an additional $6,240 used from April, $960 to use in April, $1,920 to use in May, $3,360 to use in July, August, and September.
Move favorable.
Second.
Motion has been properly made and properly second. All those in favor? All those opposed? Thank you, sir.
I'm going to stay here for the chief.
Stay there.
You're going to stay here for the chief? Okay. I just also want to acknowledge our new CFO who's sitting in the audience. It's interesting how you get called up here, but these guys don't even give you a chance to come up and say anything.
We'll give them a break.
All right, Madam Clerk, number four, please.
Acceptance and expenditure of additional grant funds in the amount of $98,938 from the Executive Office of Health and Human Services Fiscal Year 19 Safe and Successful Youth Initiative Grant to City of Brockton Police Department Fiscal Year 19 Safe and Successful Youth Initiative Grant Fund. Invited Troy Clarkson, Chief Financial Officer, John Crowley, Chief of Police, or his designee.
Captain?
Nice
to see you again.
Nice to see you. This is our supplementary appropriations to grants already approved for $98,636 additional funds, originally funded through March. $68,000 of the funds are fully funded to our SSY program through June 30th.
I motion to recommend favorably.
Second.
The motion has been question on the motion, Council Fowle.
Yeah, I'm not opposed to this, but something jumped out at me in the paperwork that was submitted. And Captain, if you know, is this just for youth who are residents in Brockton? And the reason I ask it is that there's been an amendment by Health and Human Services, and their strategy is focused on proven risk youth who are identified by each city or town as the individuals most likely to be perpetrators or victims of shooting or stabbing violence. And then on the second page, they define an eligible individual as someone who is 17 to 24 years old who, and under item I, repeatedly engages in weapons violence or crimes against persons. So I guess my question is, I have no problem trying to save people who perhaps have gotten themselves caught up in some violence and they can be rehabilitated, but I would be concerned if we were going to become a regional focal point for this. So is it just Brockton residents or is it a regional?
I thought so, but I'm not sure. I don't know.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Councilor.
Mr. Chairman, just point of information, subsection B under that same subsection does say currently resides in the community or is expected to be released into the community, which I believe in some cases is people being released to a halfway house or whatever.
Yeah.
Back into Brockton.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Any other questions?
No.
Again, the motion has been, a motion was made and properly second. All those in favor of recommending it favorably? All those opposed?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Councilors, I guess that's the end of our agenda. I believe it's 7:15.
Get a record.
We have five minutes to go, right?
No.
Council Borger.
Yes, I'd like a moment of personal privilege.
You may.
Yes, I'd like maybe a couple of moments, actually. All right. It would appear that national news, we're hearing some rather distressing behavior by some, I refer to them as parental units, that are quite famous and had trouble getting their kids into colleges. I want to point out that in Brockton, we have more kids getting into colleges, and they do it the honest and earnest way. And if they're not just doing that, they're, making the finals once again to a drama club or winning choral awards throughout the state, and the band is too, and that's, I'm not even going into sports. And I just believe that's worth noting. I mean, this is quite alarming, the behavior of the parents that want to get their kids into schools the non-honest way. And I wanted to make a mention of that. I also wanted to thank publicly Senator Brady for supporting the infrastructure bill, which I hope that all of you will contact him, 617-722-1200, because it is quite obvious that we need our streets paved. The number one concern of residents of the city is getting their streets paved. And actually, it's almost hard to find a street that doesn't need to be paved. And I wanted to bring that up, and welcome back. You were missed, and thank you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Councilor Isaac.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would like to invite everybody to Brockton High School's annual spring performance, for the Brockton High School Band this Wednesday, April 3rd at 7 p.m. in the high school auditorium. The tickets are only $4, and this is everybody's chance to see an award-winning band and an amazing performance for only $4. So hope to see everybody this Wednesday. Tickets can be purchased at the door or, I believe, at the main office. Speaking about arts, I would also like to congratulate, as my colleague, Councilor Beauregard, mentioned, our Brockton High School Drama Club was named state champions, I believe, this past week for their performance of Magic Theater. So they are an outstanding, we have outstanding arts for our kids at the high school, and they are well deserving of being named state champions. They will also put on this spring the spring musical, which is Newsies. It's usually sometime mid-May, so everybody save the date. It's always a great, great time. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilor. Councilor Monahan.
Mr. Chairman, a moment of personal privilege.
Go for it, sir.
Got the date. April 18th, I will be having a ward meeting at George's Cafe, 6:30. I'll remind you later on when I have the list of guests completed. So April 18th, George's Cafe, first one under the new ownership. I'm going to be dealing with them guys. They'll be down there, too, giving a little talk. So thank you.
Thank you. I was actually there on Saturday, and it was a pretty nice time, and it looks like those guys are going to be doing a great job in keeping it. George's and basically just about everything else. Councilor Cruz?
Actually, just on behalf of my colleague who couldn't make it tonight, just a reminder to the members of the Ordinance Committee that Wednesday evening we have a meeting right here in this chamber. 6 o'clock, I believe. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilor. Councilors, anything else? Having absolutely no further business of the people of the city of Brockton, this meeting is adjourned.
That's what you think.